Back in 2005, I married my husband Stu on Diani Beach, Kenya at the Leopard Beach Resort. We didn't bring any friends or family members, so Esther and Steve, who worked at the resort, volunteered to be our maid of honor and best man. I promised my maid of honor, Esther, that I would come to her wedding when it was her turn. April 20th, 2013 was that day. We started our journey to the Taita Hills in Kenya with nearly 24 hours of flying from New York City to Nairobi. We then joined my husband's best man Steve and some of his friends for the 6-hour drive to Sorova Taita Hills Game Lodge. Minutes after we arrived, we were on our first game drive into Taita Hills. After the game drive, we headed up to Nayati Point and enjoyed a sundowner with our new friends. Beer, barbecue, and the setting Kenyan sun relaxed us for the big wedding the next day. The next morning we got up extra early. Stu left to chase lions with his new friend Anthony on another game drive. I went to go see Esther get ready to walk down the aisle. See those tattoos on her arms? They are henna tattoos that all her bridal party had on their arms and body. I thought they looked beautiful. The ceremony was held at the base of the Taita Hills on a perfect day under some perfect fluffy clouds. Ah, here comes the bride. Thank you. After the ceremony, we headed back to the lodge for some celebratory dancing. The dance is known as Kishawi, which is a traditional Taita dance. The wedding reception started with even more dancing. Was a combination of Swahili and Taita delicacies and was delicious. After the speeches and toasts, Esther and Francis cut the cake and the bridal party passed us each a morsel. One of the cakes was presented to Francis's mother, and the other to Esther's mother. It was now time for the bride and groom to get their gifts. Thank you. One of the gifts was a pair of goats. The goats are given by a Maasai elder to a fellow elder when he is getting married. It was a special gift for Francis from the Maasai elders in Maasai Mara, where he works. We have never been to a wedding where the bride and groom receive goats. After the reception, we drove to Francis's home village, Bawala.
Go, Salome, go!
The bride, Esther, wasn't allowed to enter her in-law's home until Francis's father gave his blessing. In this case, he gave a little monetary gift.
One meeting, please.
And then we got to dance some more. And the whole village celebrated Esther and Francis's marriage.
Thank you.
One more cake cutting and Esther and Francis left for the hotel for the wedding dinner, and the village children danced for the rest of the evening. And if you thought the night was over then, you would be wrong. We returned back to the lodge where we all drank and danced until the wee hours of the morning. Thank you, Esther and Francis, for inviting us to your wedding, and may you be happy for all of your days.
Never don't why you there, manakamano. Chinga to bewa we ye, manakamano. Dakmawada kepini, and manazawadi. Chinga to bewa we ye, manakamano, jayada. Luru chick manosekor, luru chick manosendik, luru in lu babadad, luru chick jatelo,